In this video, I'm going to talk about six no-code and AI tools that you should learn now to be ready for 2025. It covers everything from mobile app development to AI automation. I'm personally really excited about number six, and it's something that I'm already using today and think it's going to become even more powerful in the next year. I also just want to say thank you for 10,000 subscribers here on YouTube. We're excited to keep bringing you more content. If there's anything you want to see from our channel, leave a comment below. And if you're new here, be sure to hit subscribe so you get all of our content right here for free. First up is Replit Agent. What's cool about Replit Agent is that not only does it generate code for you using AI, it does all of the backend setup necessary when you are coding. So it'll install all the packages, it'll set up your database, it will handle all of those kind of administrative tasks that otherwise, even if you're using a tool like Cursor, you're going to have to set up and know how to do. With Replit, it really takes care of everything. So you tell it what you want to build, and then it goes through and actually builds it. So here we can see just an example. I have other videos where I go through full examples of how to build with Replit Agent, but you tell it what you want to build. It's going to basically go into a chatbot and ask you if there's any features that you want to add to it and kind of solidify your plan. Then it's going to go through and actually set up your app, like I mentioned before. It'll ask to add API keys, such as an OpenAI key or any other API key that you need to connect to other services. And then you'll be able to actually test the functionality directly in Replit on your screen and debug with the Replit agent. So it's kind of like working with an AI software developer. Now, by 2025, I expect Replit Agent to become really, really powerful and go from where it is right now, which is where it's really good for prototyping basic apps, but it runs into more trouble when you're trying to do something more complex. I expect that next year, it's going to get to the point where it is going to be able to do things that are a lot more complex and complicated without running into as many bugs. I have also read that they're going to implement different design templates so that your apps look better right from the start by building with Replit Agent. So I wouldn't even be surprised if in the future we kind of assume that an app is built with Replit Agent just based on how it looks, based on the basic design templates that it has. But I think that this tool is only going to get a lot better in 2025. So this is one that I highly recommend checking out and spend a little bit of time with it now. It's worth paying for a 1 month access of their premium plan on Replit just to check out Replit Agent. I think that it might just be a part of the future of building with no code. The next thing coming soon, and that I think is going to be really big in 2025, is Bubble's native mobile app builder. So with Bubble, you're going to be able to build not only web apps the way that you can right now, but native apps that you can put on the Apple App Store or the Google Play Store, and you're going to be able to use the same database that you have for your existing web apps or build new apps that just use a Bubble database. So I think that this is going to be one of the coolest no-code tools to be using in 2025. I think it's going to unlock a ton of use cases for people who already know Bubble, who want to learn Bubble to build mobile apps. Building mobile apps is something that is a little bit more challenging right now with no code compared to web apps. There are some tools that I'm going to talk about later that are really powerful and do allow you to build mobile apps, but I think that this is going to be a really exciting one. They're just releasing it out of beta right now, so if you go on Twitter, you can see different people talking about it, and people who've used it have really positive things to say. But by 2025, it should be available, and this is one that you're going to want to go and add yourself to the wait list. If you search for Bubble native mobile app, you'll get to this page, and then you'll be able to be one of the first people to build native apps using Bubble. This video is brought to you by No-Code MBA. If you want to learn about building with no-code and AI tools, how to build your own web and mobile apps and AI automations, check the link in the description or go to nocode.mba today to check out all of our in-depth courses. The next tool that I want to talk about is bolt.new. This is a tool that is kind of going viral right now, and I think by 2025, it is going to be one of the key no-code tools that you could use to build prototypes. It's a little bit like Replit Agent, where you can tell Bolt what you want to build, and then it's going to take care of actually writing the code and a lot of the setup for you. So just as an example, if I wanted to say I'd like to build an AI text generation app. So I can go in and let it know I want to build it. It's going to be a little bit similar to Replit Agent, where it's going to have a chatbot here. And then it's going to start building. And we can see if you've used Replit Agent before, this might be similar, where on one side we have kind of a chat interface, and on the other side we have an interface where it's actually writing the code. From my experience using Bolt so far, it doesn't go quite as far where it's completely setting up the back end for you. It does tell you how to set up the back end. So there's certain times when, you know, as you can see here, to use the app, it's telling me I need to enter in the API key and the environment file. I need to run the development server. So it's a little bit more than what I can do with Replit, where Replit kind of does these things for you and it'll pop up with a box and ask you to put in your OpenAI key. But my bet is that Bolt is going to get to the point where it takes care of everything and all of that setup for you. So this is one that you're going to want to check out now, get ahead of the curve. And then you can see it already built this interface in about 20 seconds, which is pretty amazing. And you also have the code here. And we can go to all the different pages in the code. We have the CSS. It's pulling in Tailwind, which is a design system, so it already is going to look pretty good right out of the box. And it's building it in React, I believe. Here, this is definitely a really, really cool one to check out. And I think that in 2025, this is only going to get a lot better. So these AI tools especially are just going to keep improving very quickly. The next tool that I highly recommend checking out now so you are ready for 2025 is FlutterFlow, especially if you want to build a native mobile app. So this is similar to Bubble, like I talked about before, but the FlutterFlow mobile app builder exists right now and you can use it, and it's really powerful. So while the Bubble one is coming soon, and we'll see how good it actually is when it is released, the FlutterFlow one is already out. And what's really great about FlutterFlow is you can have your own separate database through Firebase or Supabase, so you're not kind of locked in to FlutterFlow the way that you are with Bubble. So there's pros and cons to that. It might be a little bit more technical to set up. It's really not that hard to set up, but that is one of the differences. But FlutterFlow is one that, again, is only getting better and better. I would say they keep adding, you know, more components. They keep adding more features to make it easier to build in FlutterFlow. It's a really great platform, especially if you want to extend it with actual code as well, which you can write with platforms like ChatGPT or other AI coding platforms. So FlutterFlow is one that I think is going to blow up a lot more in 2025 as more and more apps are built on FlutterFlow, more and more people have success with FlutterFlow, then that's going to be something that people see and want to build their own app on FlutterFlow. So this is one that I predict is going to grow a lot in the next year. The next tool that I think is going to get a lot more popular in 2025 is Glide. Glide is a way to build apps without writing code, and you can connect to any backend. One of the more popular backends, though, is just connecting to a Google Sheet, which is really great, or you can connect to Glide's own backend as well, or bring your own backend. And what is great about Glide, and what I think is going to help it really explode in 2025, is its new AI features that it's built into its platform. So what Glide is allowing you to do is take your own business data. So it's really meant for building more internal apps as opposed to external apps. and take your own internal data and run it through AI models and then make changes programmatically to that data or take action on that data in your app. You can set it so Glide automatically is going to select the best model for every use case. It automatically selects different models for working with text, image, audio, documents, so you can focus on getting the actual results instead of actually going into the details of each model. So it's really great for people who are non-technical and just want to build apps that integrate with AI and integrate with their own business data. So Glide is one that I think is only going to get more popular in 2025. And if you want to get ahead of the curve, I definitely recommend checking it out today. So you are ready for all of the new features that they're going to be building and ready for it to become a more and more popular tool. The last tool that I think is going to get more popular and really blow up in 2025 is Make. So you may have heard of Make before. It's a little bit like Zapier where you can build workflows. I think it is a little bit easier with Make to build more complex workflows. It's also less expensive than Zapier. And where I think Make is going to really get popular is for building AI workflows. So the way Make works, you can see right here, the workflows have different modules. So there's a trigger, and then there's different things that happen as a result of that trigger. And one of the modules that you can add is an OpenAI or Anthropic module, which is going to allow you to send an API call to those platforms and get a response back using AI. So what's really great about this is you can connect AI into any workflow that you want, and then you're able to get those results and take action on it and build it all within this drag and drop platform Make. So I have another video on YouTube where I built out an AI social media posting automation using Make by using those AI modules inside of the automation and having it actually post to our social platforms automatically. So that's just one example, but I think there are going to be so many more workflows that you're going to see people building and that you could build using Make, and I think it's only going to become more and more popular in 2025 and something that I think is really useful today and only going to become more useful as these AI models become more and more powerful. Thanks for watching. By learning and using these tools now, you're going to be well positioned for 2025, whether you want to build your own business or earn money building for others. Subscribe to our YouTube channel to get all of our content here for free, and leave a comment if you have any questions. Thanks, and I'll see you in the next video.